What is going on YouTube? I figure I can make a little quick video as we're traveling westbound I-10 through Tallahassee on our way to Mobile, Alabama. I want to just put a quick video about proper mirror adjustments to help eliminate blind spots. Now, when your mirrors are properly adjusted, you can actually eliminate a lot of things. It'll actually help you back more straighter. You can actually see the way your truck is going. You can actually kind of get a better feel for your truck, knows who's all around you. Your mirrors should not be trying, your door flat mirrors, the big flat mirrors, should not be aimed and looking at your rear trailer tires. I notice a lot of people have their mirrors like that. I don't know what they're looking for because it's not on the road where it should be. With proper mirror adjustment, being on the door flat mirror, it's a nice big mirror, your main mirror that everyone uses. When you're looking down your mirror, on the outer edge of the mirror towards the inside. So if you got like a mirror like this, on this edge portion here, at least 2-3 inches from the bottom of it, once your truck is fully straight in the line, you should be able to graze that red dot. So when you look at it, you should be able to see the red dot showing just a smidge. And when you go to lean and look, you can get a much better view. You can look at your tires, you can check everything, see what's around you. Now, with that being said, that mirror itself, when you're sitting stationary, should be clearly eligible to see at least 2 lanes of highway to your left and 2 lanes of highway to the right. The same thing you do for the left will be the same thing you do for the right. You're supposed to be able to see the highway on both sides, your road lanes on both sides. You know, make sure that dot is aligned. Now, when it comes to the mirror below that, now, what we're talking about is the inner edge portion of the mirror, the place that's closest to you. With the door convex mirrors, the ones that's below you, you should be able to see the outer edge of your sleeper on both sides. When it's properly adjusted, you'll see the outer edge on your sleeper, which means that depending on your correct seating position, you want to position your mirror so you can see the outer edge on the most inner portion. Now, sometimes it might be pushing that mirror all the way out. Sometimes, you know, it might be that way. Depends on how you're sitting. Now, everybody's seating position is different. Now, the rule of thumb with that, you should be able to see exactly 3 to 6 lanes to your left and 3 to 6 lanes to your right when your mirror is adjusted properly on the other side. Now, when it comes to your hood mirrors, you need to be able to see the bend of the door mirror. Now, when you set it, now you have a whole mirror and you got that on the mirror, you have like the top corner, right? And on that top corner, you should be able to see the door mirror in that top corner. Now, again, sometimes it might sit, you might see it in the middle. Sometimes you might see it on a, you know, in the corner, somewhere near the corner. But that's the rule of thumb. You should be able to see the L bend in the top left corner of the passenger mirror and the top right corner of the driver mirror on your truck. Now, sometimes it might call for you pushing the mirrors all the way out. I guarantee you, personally guarantee you, that if you can set your mirrors up properly, it will eliminate blind spots. Now, I'm not telling you, I'm going to just drive like this. I'm not going to do my leans and my checks and all that. That's what you do. You check what's around you, you still check. But when you're going down the highway, you can properly see your mirrors. If you lean like this, if you give a head lean, I can literally get a quick glance of all 3 mirrors because they're properly aligned. If I lean that way, by the time my eyes go here and come back, I done seen everything that's right there because it's properly aligned, okay? Proper alignment of mirrors. I'm gonna tell you another thing. With your door convex mirrors, if you're passing someone, And, you know, you have to lean, make sure your trailer's clear, get both headlights in your driver mirror, you can change lanes. Now, what a lot of drivers do, because their mirrors aren't properly set, and they going from a left lane to a right lane, your mirrors aren't properly set, you're looking at the tire. Rule of the main rule is that you should be able to see both headlights of the vehicle you pass in your passenger mirror if you're passing in the left lane before you begin your lane change. Now, there's a lot of drivers who have it misaligned, looking at the tires, and you get past the driver, you think you passed them, really and truly, you just cut that driver off 5 feet. Now you just upset the driver because that's in life endangering. The proper way to change lanes is if you're passing someone and my mirrors are properly adjusted and I see both headlights in that mirror, I know that I have at least 30 to 50 feet of clearance from the vehicle that I just passed in order for me to safely merge over. Now, there are times where other drivers might flash you to get over and things like that. Does not mean that you get over right away. That does not mean you jump over right away. You still always check your mirrors, because how many of us drivers have been out there, turn your signal light on, and as soon as you get a clearance, you go to move, and there's a driver come shooting up behind you. Okay? You get a driver come shooting up behind you. Now, that's the thing. That's the rule of thumb. Only, you know, I just wanted to put that out there for the moment, because, you know, there are a lot of drivers who, number one, aren't given that knowledge, and number two, lack that knowledge. So this is information that you can share, and, you know, go from there. Remember, the journey starts with you. Get home safe. Go out safe, play safe, ride safe. One.